Hello there, the gang's all here for this week's Care in the Kitchen. Because we have a special guest, Mike German.
Hi.
From 328 Grill over in St. Paul.
St. Paul Park, yeah.
St. Paul Park, glad to have you here.
I'm happy to be here.
You're in an American Legion.
American right? Legion, yeah, American Legion Post 98.
I love it.
I hear those are fun places to hang
they're
out.
They're great places to hang
they're
out.
They're the best.
Oh, I've played bingo there so many times.
It's like the place to play bingo.
Right.
Any Legion
Tuesday night
offers
in St. Paul Park, bingo night, 6:30, don't miss it.
It's rare, though, that you got, like, a really good chef and a really, I mean, Legions all have their own food thing. And
usually,
it's deep fried bar food.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Which is fine.
Which
it's
is
like
great.
Bowling, bowling alley food. Which
yeah, well, it's not, you're not far off.
It does the job. But you guys are, like, leveling up tenfold.
Elevated.
We're trying to. Mm-hmm. And we're also trying to help other American Legions and VFWs kind of do the same thing.
Smart.
So tell us about your menu. You're the owner and the chef.
Yes, ma'am.
You do it all.
Yep. Well, I do a lot. I got an incredible staff, so. But we do a lot. I don't want to say it's bar food. It's more than bar food. Everything is scratch. Like we make everything in house.
Yum.
You'll see on our Reuben. It takes us a week to make the pastrami for our Reuben.
No,
it's a bison pastrami.
Bison pastrami.
A little different.
Yeah. Our wild rice soup, which you're gonna see on the poutine here in a little bit, is we make it in house almost every day because we go through that much.
Yum.
That looks ridiculous.
Thank you.
The cheese is already melted.
Ellsworth cheese curds, of course.
Of
right?
course.
It's the only way to go is Ellsworth.
No other cheese curds. Sexy stir.
Sexy stir.
I got it. On TV.
Oh! Look at that goo.
Okay.
I'm always curious
when
it comes to the people that come in here and cook. What is your chef origin story? Like, where did you start cooking?
Yeah.
When did you
my
start
mom.
Cooking?
Okay.
Oh, and it's always my mom.
My mom was a restaurant cook, server, front of the house manager. I was a kid. We were poor, didn't have a lot of money, and like high chair at the end of the line while mom cooked lunch, and that's kind of just been doing it forever.
And then you learn from her. I love it.
I'm 28 years into cooking.
That's amazing, and it smells so good.
Thank you.
So talk about the menu. What do you said? Elevated bar food.
We
today
do
you're making
Minnesota poutine, which is our tots that are seasoned with my rib rub. So I own a company called 14 Spice.
They're a little, they're not the warmest anymore.
They're not the warmest anymore. That's right.
Mm-hmm. The rib rub on those things are
but
dangerous.
This here, this is going to warm up all of those.
Oh my gosh,
that's really good.
Oh my goodness.
So it's just it's the creaminess, it's the gooiness. It's
that is naughty.
You know?
So where did you get the idea
oh my gosh,
poutine
here. Hold on, I'm taking a picture of that.
Using Minnesota wild rice instead
honestly,
of the normal
know.
Poutine recipe.
What I tell everybody is my brain is a weird place.
it's a weird place that I like to be.
Yeah,
well, good.
Yeah. I'll live there.
We do a burger of the week every week, mm-hmm. and I have a list on my phone of, I probably have 60 or 70 different burger ideas that are just random ideas, like something pops in my head, it's a name or an ingredient or just something I want to do, and Minnesota poutine was kind of part of that. Like, I was like, I want to do a poutine, but I want to do it different, and wild rice soup was on the menu at the place I was working at.
That's
and
so smart.
Mm-hmm. So I haven't seen this. I've seen so many poutines.
Yeah.
I've never seen one with wild rice soup.
This is the most unique thing that I've ever seen.
It's Minnesota in a bowl.
Everyone?
How old are those?
How old are you?
Can I eat one?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, I'll eat them. Are they both bison?
Bison Reuben. Jeez, and then the other one is our faux cheesy, which is just regular, well, not regular ground beef. It's a very nice ground beef that we use. That's some serious cheese pull on
this
that bite.
This is a cheese
Look
pull.
Look at that. Like, oh, my gosh.
YouTube
Welcome
worthy.
To Minnesota right there.
Right?
Wow.
OMG.
We'll give a little credit to Wisconsin for those Ellsworth curds, but yeah.
Mm.
Mm.
What's not to like, right?
I have no words.
If anybody
Yum.
Has family in from out of town, bring them in, and this is Minnesota. Teach them.
Wow.
That's really good. Yeah,
that is Thank gangster,
you.
Dude.
That is so yummy. So you were talking about bringing more people into the St. Paul Park area.
Yeah.
What else is going on?
In St. Paul Park?
Yeah, besides you guys.
We've got a handful. It's a very small downtown. Like, St. Paul Park's a town of 5,500 people, but we're 10 minutes from the Capitol. Like, you know, we're right there, but it's a small community. Now that's what I'm talking about.
Oh my God, what have I done? How do I, I'm just gonna, here we go.
It's like spaghetti.
Okay.
Got distracted by the amount of cheese.
I love it.
That is so
that's
good.
That's amazing.
St. Paul Park is a great spot.
It's a great little community. So I live in Cottage Grove, so I'm like the next town over. I'm 3 miles from work. But it's just a really nice small community. Everybody knows each other. Everybody supports each other. It's a small community that's just trying to be like, hey, we're here, come see us, you know?
What else is on your menu? So Johnny, how is that bison bite?
Got some nice spice to it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take
a bite. The bison's
not
too gamey, but it's got a little bit of
it. It's got a little bit, but it's in a brine for a week, so it takes a lot of that gaminess out.
Yeah, no, it's good.
If you didn't know it was bison, you wouldn't know
it's
bison.
It's just got a tiny bit of the gaminess, but Again, you like for me, I come accustomed to that. I like that.
Yeah, so it's a week-long process to get this bison ready.
Yep. Yeah, that's and it comes local from a place called Silver Bison Ranch in Baldwin, Wisconsin.
Hmm. Really?
Yep. I love that a lot right of your there, ingredients local. Are like super local.
We try anytime that we can, we do. As long as it works for us and it works for, you know, who we're getting it from, we do it.
Mm-mm-mm. All right, so 328
yep.
Grill, is that the address?
Mm. 328 Broadway, yep.
Mm.
Smart.
Clever.
Well, no, I wouldn't say it's clever.
That's dangerous,
My wife and I couldn't figure out a name for the place, so we're like, what's the address? 328 Grill sounds great.
I like it.
How long have you guys been there?
It'll be 3 years in April.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. This is so good. Bingo's Tuesday.
Bingo's Tuesday. Fish fry every Friday.
Mm. We were just talking about
fish fry. Meat raffle on Friday.
Minnesota, baby.
So my favorite
That's Minnesota.
I love the meat raffle.
He had his first meat raffle this summer, and he's like, what are we doing?
Are we going to take a bite of that, too?
I mean, you got it.
Yeah, what is this?
So
exactly.
It's called the faux cheesy.
Mm-hmm.
It's called faux cheesy because there's four cheeses on it. It's got a Parmesan butter crust, American cheese on the patty, cheddar cheese, and pepper jack cheese whiz on the inside of the bread.
Okay,
pepper jack cheese whiz?
Pepper jack cheese whiz.
Look at that. Look at the layers there. Look at that.
So it's gooey, it's beefy, it's cheesy. It's got that nice crust from the outside, so you got good texture.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What are you guys' hours again?
We're open 11 to 8 Monday through Saturday and 11 to 6 on Sunday.
I love it.
People are going to want to check this out.
I hope they do.
I want to come check it out.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys
I love a good Legion. I love good food.
Come in, we can show you the whole process of how we make the pastrami.
Oh, I'd love that. I have a smoker at home. I've been wanting to pastrami, but it seems daunting.
I'll send you home with one. You can smoke it.
Stop it. You guys heard it here first. No. Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you. I appreciate you guys having
Megan,
me.
Geez.
Also, I want to give a shout out to your apron.
Yes.
Craft-made apron with the great custom apron.
It's
I love this thing.
At far away, you're like, oh, cool colors. And then you get closer, you're like,
I'm a burger guy, if you couldn't tell.
That's awesome.
You are my hero.
Thank Chef.
You. Appreciate it.
Bravo, Thanks, sir. Guys. Bravo. Come back Good anytime.
Stuff. Anytime you want me, I'll be here.
Well, we're eaters.
The crust on this is absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah.
Johnny said he started a diet today. He was eating egg whites this morning. He's yeah, like on the deep end.
Why are you here?
Burgers.
Just to make your heart happy, man.
Yeah. Happy heart.
Is that cheese crust on top?
Yeah, dude.
Parmesan butter crust.
Parmesan butter crust.
Yum. All right, we're going to pig out. Thanks for watching.
Thanks.